I think it's time to sleep. What's this video?
And as always, I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye!
Alright, just one more.
Thanks for watching. If you like that, please subscribe and check
it out. I have to go to sleep right now. No, enough! I'm going to sleep right now. I wonder what's on Instagram. So, how did I force myself to go to sleep in time? At first I wanted something tame like some flashing lights with an alarm. But let's be honest here, there's a much better way to learn something. Whoa. No, I have not gone crazy, I'm just sleep deprived. Woof! I wanted to build a device that I could rest my dogs on, then tase them if I went to bed too late. Oh! problem. One, the electricity could go through my balls, which might or might not make them explode. And second, I'm not going to let you see my feet. For free. Give me your money. Anyways, here's the plan.
Men only want one thing.
Wrong. We're going to need three things. Electronics. Yeah, we got electronics, but what's gonna hold them together? That's right, a PCB. It's pretty neat and everything, but it's boring, so we gotta this part, that, this and that one, so that we can go part by part to slice everything up. Then upload the files to a microSD card, which we're going to force feed to the 3D printer, and just like that, the project is done. Nah, just kidding, a package has just arrived. Can you guess what it is? Of course, it's the sponsor who will help this abomination come to life. PCB Bay. I just do this, and we're done. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. Before soldering everything, I had to test out if the board even worked.
Bruh, why is it so short?
Always expect the worst when you're testing your new inventions for the first time.
Please don't explode. Alright, so far so good. Save this switch. And now it should work. Oh! Yes, it works! Yes!
And it's always a relief when something works for the first time.
But it's not done yet.
Also, here's a lesson.
I'm hoping that the module won't destroy this. Oh,
Always unplug the power before making any modifications to a circuit.
Okay. Everything's good.
Now we can go ahead and assemble the device. Well, whatever. The new one should fit.
Well, I guess I forgot to do the second task.
Third time's the charm. What about the shell?
It doesn't fit.
Things are starting to come together. So this is gonna be the top.
Wait.
Hold up, Lidico, what are you even making? You spend all this time building something and you don't even explain what it is.
You want an explanation? You want an explanation? Fine, I'll give you an explanation.
The idea is that as your bedtime approaches, the device warns you that it's time to go to sleep soon. You do your typical night routine and just before you lay on your bed, you rest your palm on the top of the device, which then calculates whenever you went to bed late or not. If you're on time, it tells you that the daily test is complete and you can take your hand off from its metal contacts. If you're late...
Oh!
But what if you know you're late and you don't wanna get shocked, so you simply don't complete your daily test? In that case, the device is gonna get angry and start beeping at maximum volume in the middle of the night for not obeying it. So choose your punishment. I originally wanted to use an adjustable high voltage module so that the later I was, the harder I got shocked. But knowing myself, I would accidentally set it to max power and electrocute myself. I was also planning to add RGB LEDs, but I didn't have time for that. As for the electronics, an Arduino is going to switch the tazer on and off with a transistor. It's not that complicated.
Oh, so that's how it's gonna work. But why does it look so damn ugly?
Oh, hell no!
Because it's a prototype. In fact, I don't even need a shell right now. Much better.
The electronics are pretty much done, now I just have to program it. And by I mean ChatGPT. I would like to try to program it myself, I just don't have the time to learn it, so...
We just paste this in and we're done. Of course, ignoring the 4 hours of debugging, redesigning, soldering and fixing. But only one thing matters.
It works.
Kinda. I don't know, there are some issues, but let's just call them features.
Oh wow, that's brilliant.
Just like today's sponsor. Brilliant. Look, I always hate school. They sit you down in front of a projector and expect you to memorize everything that comes up on the screen. But that way of teaching is so inefficient, it's laughable. I have been studying electrical engineering for 3 years now, and the only things that ever stuck were the lessons I learned through building projects like these. And this is where Brilliant comes in, because instead of the typical boring lectures you see all over the internet, it uses interactive, hands-on lessons with plenty of visuals so that you can actually get a grasp of what you're learning. Let's say you want to start building circuits, but you don't know where to start. Well, guess what? There's a course on that. You don't know how to program? Now you do. Algebra, AI, statistics, data science, anything you want really. The point is that it's fun, it's addictive, and I'm actually saying that from personal experience, and a useful way to spend your time. So if you're interested, you can try Brilliant's 30-day free trial by going to brilliant.org/blidical or simply clicking the first link in the description or the pinned comment, or even by scanning the QR code on the screen. You also get 20% off an annual premium subscription.
Oh man, that's awesome, but are you going to upgrade the prototype or not?
I want it to have some patience! The first option is when you're on time so you don't get tased. But be honest, you didn't come for this. You just wanna see me get tased, huh? You wanna see me get... I know why you're here. You wanna see me suffer. And you know what? Fine. I think this thing is dead now, so I think this is the end of the road. You had a good run, buddy. Thanks for watching this stupid video, I hope you hated it. I think it's time to sleep now. But what about one more? Maybe tomorrow.